Hi, I'm the Shadow Snows and I'm back with episode 24 of my Test Drive Unlimited series. And in this episode I will try the big challenge, which is probably not too big of a challenge. And it surely is one of the longer races. I mean, 60 kilometers, and I got 20 minutes time for it, which should be plenty. And I'm doing it in one of my favorite cars, which should make it even easier. And the only thing I hate about this race so far is that you only got one checkpoint. And as long as I drive faster than 180, I'm gaining time. So this, so far, feels like a pretty easy race. Only challenging thing is probably that you have to be focused for 20 minutes. And you don't even get the police into this race, so yeah, it's really not one of the harder races. Yeah, and I took less than 3 minutes for the first 10 kilometers. Shit! I mean, it doesn't really matter, but shit anyways. And I really find those quite easy long races very relaxing. I think I've driven the island tour like 50 times in different cars, and I probably will do this in this video, and not in this video, but in this series. So yeah, if you want me to drive the island tour in a particular car, I will do it, even though it's not possible to win in every car. It should be possible in most A, B and C class cars. But nonetheless, Maybe it's also interesting how long it takes in the Audi TT or something like that. I have driven the island tour in the vintage Lamborghini before. But I don't think I finished first. I think I made it third. But it, unless you got a wheel, a steering wheel, I think it's impossible to win the island tour with a Lamborghini. With a steering wheel, I could imagine that I might do it. But since I don't have one, I cannot tell. And of course you need a good steering wheel. You have to be very precise then. And that's really not possible with a controller. I mean, I really prefer playing with the controller over playing with the keyboard in those games, but for a really serious racer, you need a wheel. But luckily, this is not really a serious racer. It does offer different options, so you can turn off some of the driving aids that I have activated, I think. I think those are the default settings, so I really don't know. What the actual settings are that I'm playing on, but I don't think I maxed out the driving aids. Or better said, I don't think the driving aids are maxed out in the default settings of this game. And it feels okay. So I can't complain too much about the controls. What I can complain about is sometimes abysmally low frame rate. And the general blandness of the landscape, especially if you played GTA 5 before, then this is very noticeable. But I also think GTA 5 was several years after this game. I mean, for some strange reason, there's no Test Drive Unlimited on the PS3. It is on the PS2, but not on the original Xbox, but on the Xbox 360. Yeah. No clue why. But just for this game, for me at least, it was worth getting the Xbox 360. I think I played at least 30 or 40 hours. Just this game so far. And I paid a tenner for the game, and I think 40 bucks for the Xbox. So that's 50 bucks for 30, 40 hours of entertainment just with this game. Paid another tenner for the GTA 5, which I also played 30 or 40 hours. Paid another tenner for Lollipop Zombies, which I honestly played maybe like 15 or 20 hours. Then I paid a fiver for GTA 4 with in the special edition with the two expansion CDs. Sad thing is, it's a German version. Good thing is, it's still in English. And at least to my knowledge, it's not censored. Yeah, and those were the games I mostly played so far. So pretty cheap entertainment. And yeah, even though this game could look a lot better, I mean, I would not mind better graphics or something like that. It looks still decent enough for me to consider this a modern game. And I really don't need a PS4 or an Xbox One. I'm totally fine with the graphics, the 360, or I also have a PS3. The PS3 will offer. And what I already hate about the PS3 is that I have to find some sort of HDCP stripper to be able to record it via HDMI output. Great move, Sony, great move. And that's also the reason why I probably won't record any PS3 footage in the near future. First of all, I still have plenty of games for the 360 that I like to play. Also, may like to long play. I mean, I don't get too many views on those videos, but it's not that much more work than just playing the game, so why not record them and publish them, if at least some people still have some entertainment out of those. And I don't get too many views, but I do get quite a bit of view time, so those who watch them seem to watch them quite a bit and obviously enjoy them. Why should someone watch a 20-minute video if he hates it, or she hates it? But most of my viewers are male anyways, so yeah, let's have some special greetings to the one or two female viewers on my channel. Yeah, there are just not too many women into retro gaming. That is a bit different with modern games. Which is not a bad thing. Also wouldn't mind more women in retro gaming. Why not? Why? I mean, not that this is going to be a problem for me to win this, but why? Kilometers left, 6 minutes. That really should not be a problem. Especially not on a quite straight road with a reasonable amount of traffic. Yeah, and the main problem is really keeping focus for that long. Shit. Okay, but 1 kilometer left. And more than 3 minutes.
Turn right.
I don't think I can drive that terrible. But I'm trying to drive that terrible, but I can't. Whew. Yeah, that was really an easy one. But gives quite a bit of money. Yeah, I'm not going to retry this, and I'm not going to do another race in this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching.